Hello kids, once again welcome back in my class. I am your mentor Nisha and once again I have come back with one more new chapter and this chapter is very interesting as usual and as I am observing that you all are doing very very nice. You are performing excellently. An awesome piece of work you are sending every day and I am so glad to see that you are being such a small kid. You are doing very great, very good work. So I appreciate each and every child, those who are following so nicely, those who are listening my videos so carefully, because when I ask question in to you, you are replying promptly. That is I'm feeling that you all are following the videos very nicely. So let's come back to the point. Today I'm going to start one more new chapter and the topic of the chapter is States of India. Yes beta, India is the country where we are living and being an Indian, we must know each and everything about India, like about its political features, its physical features, neighboring countries and in which continent India is lying. So each and everything we must know about India. So today I am going to start this chapter and we will discuss about each and every point. So today I have taken the part, political part of India. It means that today I am going to start that how many states are there, how many capitals are there, how many union territories are there, what are states, what are capitals, what are union territories. Okay, fine. So let's start. First point is India is a vast country. Yes, the word vast. But actually, if you ask that, ma'am, what is the meaning of the word vast? It is little a new word for you children. Word vast means very huge in size. It's not small in size. It actually means very big in size, very huge in size. Jo size mein bahut bada hota hai. So yes, India is a vast country. It means in size it is very huge. Fine. So first point we have done. Second is location. It means that where this country is located. Which country I am talking about? I am talking about India. So what is the exact location of India? Actually beta, India is lying near a continent which name is Asia. Yes, the world largest continent in the world. There are 7 continents in the world and out of 7 continents, Asia is the continent which is the first and the largest continent in the world. And we are so lucky to be the part of such a big continent. And where is the location of India related to Asia? It is located near the southern side of Asia. Asia has 4 different directions, north, south, west and east. So I am talking about the western part of Asia. Here is north, here is east, here is south and here is west. So in southern part of Asia, we are attached. India is such a great country which is located near the southern part of Asia. Okay. Now come to the next point. India is the 7th largest country in the world. Yes, India is having its own rank being the largest country in the world. Yes, it is scoring 7th rank on the world being the largest country. Okay, so this is I have marked here 7th largest country. So if you are asked that name the 7th largest country in the world, so what will be the answer? Answer will be yes, India is the 7th largest country in the world. Fine. Now stretches from Jammu and Kashmir to Kanyakumari in the south. Now what is the meaning of the word stretches? The word stretch means like stretching. A rubber is stretched means the extension, extended part. So India is starting, is extending from north to south. And what are the places from north to south? Actually, this is the northern part. This is the eastern part. This is the western part. And obviously this is southern part. Yes. So in northern part there is Jammu and Kashmir, fine, and in southern part there is Kanyakumari. So these are two extreme points First is Jammu and Kashmir, northern side, and at the southern part there is Kanyakumari. So it is starting from Jammu and Kashmir and reaching to Kanyakumari. You can see it is the topmost point and it is the bottommost point. So here is northern part, Jammu and Kashmir lying here. Here is southern part where Kanyakumari is lying. So now you see such a great stretches. India is stretched from extreme north to extreme south. So it is very huge in size. Fine, in south. Next is India. India is a country which is not whole and soul in itself. It is not whole and soul one piece, one single country in itself. Actually, different states in India makes it complete in itself. So India has been divided into different states. So how many states are there? There are 28 states. How many states are there? There are 28 states. Suppose how? I'm showing you how. Fine. Suppose this is a complete whole country in itself. Now these are divided. Suppose I'm randomly dividing just for your better conception, just to make your concept clear here. Suppose this is the division. Fine. Don't follow this. You have to follow your map in the book, which is already given. States has been divided, and all the states has been depicted by different colors. That is the exact and real division of the state, a division of country according to state. But here you are a small kid, so randomly I am showing you that how these are divided. These are the division of the country, and these particular blocks are given a particular part that is called state. So including all these states, these are 28 states. Yes. In how many times these blocks are divided? These blocks are divided into 28 times, and each time is called state. There are how many states? There are 28 states. It means that whole country is divided into 28 states part. Fine. And 9 union territories. Yes. There are 9 union territories, and what are union territories, that I will discuss little later. Fine. Next is, every state has their own capital. Yes, what is capital? That also I will follow just after some minutes. Now you see that each and every state, you know, each and every state has a whole country is divided into different states, and each and every state is having their own capital. Now just for your better understanding, let me connect state, country, its state with school. Now you will ask that, ma'am, how? Actually beta, suppose for example there is a school. Fine. So to regulate a school, to conduct a school, it is not possible for a single body to take care of everything regarding administration, related to teaching, handling parents, and everything, all the affairs we do in the school, that is not possible to be handled by a single body. So what do we have? We have a, suppose we have school here. Fine. There is an organization which is named school. Fine. So this is the complete and whole organization which has to be administered. School kya hai? Ek aisi organization hai jisko chalana hai, jisko regulate karna hai. So this is not possible for a single person to regulate everything. Ek insaan ke liye possible nahi hota hai ki puri school ko aap अकेले चलाओगे. बच्चों को पढ़ाना, हैंडलिंग द पेरेंट्स एंड ऑल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन एंड मैनेजमेंट पार्ट. सो व्हाट इज डन, हियर इज अ स्कूल एंड अ स्कूल इज हैविंग एन ओनर. फाइन, एन ओनर इज हैविंग अ प्रिंसिपल. फाइन, एंड बिलो प्रिंसिपल देयर इज अ There are some other bodies like vice principal, coordinators and teachers. So I'm including all them into one category. I'm taking them in teachers category. Fine. And after this, there are subject teachers. Fine. So now you see that this complete organization has been split into different parts. The school has been split in is related to owner, and owner is appointing a principal to handle to have the command over it, and the teachers are working under the principal. And next we have subject teachers. Fine. So class teacher is there, no? Similarly, this is the whole country, and just for a one person it is not possible to regulate it properly. So these has been divided into different state, and each and every state is having their own capital, and there they have a state government. In this way we can relate that these things are almost same. So this is all about our country, and just for the better and smooth functioning of the state, smooth functioning of a whole country administration wise and everything, these are divided into different states. Now we will discuss about what are states and what are capitals. Now let's we start about what are states and what are capitals, because states and capitals all comes together. If there is a state, definitely it will be having a capital. Fine. So what are states? What are state? State is a polity under a system of governance. It means that when there is a matter of a country, so as I have already told you in my last click, that as India is a huge country, very big, it's a vast country, so it is not possible for a single body to regulate everything at one hand. So responsibilities has been divided into different terms, and these terms are known as states. So states are actually division of a country. Fine. So these are divided into different states so that the regulation, the maintenance, the law and order can be passed smoothly. All the law and order which are passed by constitution, by the parliament, that all can be effectively worked at a particular manner. So this is all about what is a state. And as I have said that there are how many states? There are 28 states. Fine. And just to relate this example once again with school, like in a classroom, like in a classroom, children are there, teachers are there, lots of teachers are coming according to their subject. Suppose we are studying five main subjects. So five different subject teachers are there. Fine. But along with five subject teachers, there is a class teacher. Yes. So what is the main function of class teacher? Is to have a hold on the class. Like there are, suppose in a classroom, classroom there are 35 students. Okay, so to have all the records about the 35 students, who is responsible, who is taking care of these 35 students? These are taken care by the class teacher. Yes, class teacher is that one, that head of the class, who is monitoring 35 children, who is monitoring the study improvement performance of the child, of each and every child, and having all the records, and where there is a improvement needed, that all having the mind of the class teacher. Fine. So it is the main task of the class teacher. But along with class teacher, there are subject teachers also. So who is teaching, who is taking care of their subject? So similarly, there are 28 states, and each and every state is having their own capital and having the state government in itself. So this is all taken care by the state government. Fine. So capital means a city or a town that is the center of the government. Yes. All the work is done at the center. Yes, that is a central government, that is a different part. But here I am talking about capital. Capital means that suppose it is a part of any state. Any state, XYZ, any state is this. So there will be a capital. Anywhere there will be a capital which will be marked by black circle. Fine. So when you see the political map of India, definitely you will find all 28 states is having its own capital marked there. Fine. So this is all about state and capital. So in next slide, I will show you that some random states I will take and I will match them with their related capitals. Now here I have taken some random states with their capital. These are not properly matched. We have to solve the matching. Let's see, start. So first of all, let me mention these are states and these are capitals. Okay. So one side, this side is of state side. Also, some states I have taken, and this side are the names of related capitals. But these are not properly related. Now we have to solve this puzzle. So which one is the first state? First is Rajasthan. So what is the capital of Rajasthan? We have seen in the book. Actually, the capital of Rajasthan is Jaipur. So we have matched Rajasthan with Jaipur. Okay. Next state is Gujarat. Gujarat is a state which is lying in the western part of the India, and its capital is Gandhinagar. So what is the capital of Gujarat? Capital of Gujarat is Gandhinagar. Fine, beta. Next is Maharashtra. Yes, Maharashtra is a state which is known as the financial capital of India. It is one of the metropolitan city, and population is very huge here. Very large population we find here. So what is the capital of Maharashtra? We find here, which is the capital over here? Yes, Mumbai. Maharashtra will be connected with Mumbai. Okay, so what is the capital of Maharashtra? Mumbai is the capital of Maharashtra. Next is Goa. Goa is one of the smallest state. Name the smallest state. It is very small. What is the capital? Its capital is Panaji. Yes. What is the capital of Goa? Goa's capital is Panaji. It is written here. Fine. Next is Telangana. Telangana is newly formed state, and Telangana, its capital is Hyderabad. Yes. What is the capital of Telangana? Hyderabad is the capital of Telangana. Fine. Now Tamil Nadu. Tamil Nadu is a state lying in the southern part of India. And what is the capital of Tamil Nadu? Its capital is Chennai. So we are matching Tamil Nadu with Chennai. Yes. Chennai is also one of the metropolitan city here. And next is Karnataka. Karnataka is a state, and its capital is Bengaluru. Bengaluru, and it is known as Bangalore also. Bangalore, Bengaluru, both are means the name of the same place. So capital of Karnataka is Bengaluru. Fine, beta. Bengaluru. Next and last newly formed state is Ladakh. Yes, this year it has been formed, and it is formed actually, I need to say, and its capital is this, Leh. Yes, it is newly formed state, and Ladakh is the name of a newly formed state. Its capital name is Leh. It is the state which is lying in the northern part of India. In the north side of India, it is located. So in this way, you will find some other states also. I have taken here near about 8 states only. 20 states are left, which you have to solve yourself, which you have to match yourself, and which we will locate with capitals in the political map of India. Okay, so in this chapter I have tried my level best to make it very interesting, right? Like as usual. So if you find any problem, you can ask me. But the map work, which is very important, take a political map and take the help of your book, and properly we have to locate all states along with the capital. And one more thing I would like to tell you, that map work, what we will do, that will be done only with the pencil, because map work has to be done with the pencil only. All names we have to fill very neatly in small words. These are some instructions which we have to follow every time at the time of filling map. So I hope all of you have enjoyed this chapter. All of you have come to know about different interesting facts about our country, as it is the 7th largest country. It is located in the southern part of Asia, you know, and it has 28 states. It has 9 union territories, and each state is having its own capital. So everything we have gone through in this chapter. So I hope you have liked my videos. I hope you have liked my explanation even. So still, if you find any difficulties, any doubt, you can drop your question over the comment section and you can ask me. Till then, take care, have a nice day, bye bye.